Hi, I'm Carol Clarke from Craftsuprint.com and I've got another great card to show you today. Another Christmas card this time, and it's a countdown to Christmas. Instead of having an advent card where you count up, this one you can count down by moving the little wheel in the middle here, and it counts down to Christmas for you. How exciting is that for children? And it has sleep stuff Santa on the front. And you've got a lovely decorated back too. And as per normal, it comes with its own matching envelope too. And of course, it folds flat to fit into its envelope. And I'll show you how to make them. First of all, you need to print out all the sheets. And there's 4 sheets for the main card. And you will need to print these onto cardstock. Something a little heavier than paper anyway. And these look like this with the wheel. You also get a gift tag and greetings and some decoupage. There's not a lot of decoupage because there's not a lot on the card and the main card itself. And we will start off with the card back. And as you've seen me do many times, you need a ruler and a scoring tool. And you've got registration marks top and bottom. And all we do is we line it up with the registration marks and score along each of those lines. So you've got 3 on the card back, none on the card, this is the card front cover. You've got a small one here on the gift tag, and you've got just 1 on the card front, which goes across just there. And then the next thing you need to do, of course, is to cut them out, which I have already done, ready for the show. If we start off again with the, and I've written on the back so I know what it is, it's the card back, and we flip it over and fold up on the bottom score line, and using a bone folder, give a good sharp crease, and fold back on itself on the next score line, and again give a good sharp crease, and if you fold up on the last score line, which is quite small, this is the glue flap or tag, whatever you want to call it, and give another sharp crease, and that will make the card back. And by having this area here, it stops the card from splaying open when it's displayed. And then we will need the card front, which looks like this. But before we attach it to the card back, you've got a little hole in the middle, and you need to make a hole. Now use whatever method you like. I've got a silent setter here, whatever will reach into the middle for you, and make a hole in the middle. Now, I think this is going to work because it's been a while since I've used this. Let's see. Yes, that's made a hole in the middle there. And then you will need the wheel, which you will have cut out, and again you've got a hole in the middle, and you need to punch or use whatever you like to do the middle there. Just make sure, yes, that's gone through. And then you will need a brad. Doesn't matter what brad, because it's not going to be seen. But if you put it through the wheel and through the card front, of course, I'm not going to be able to fit it through, am I? And open up on the back. Don't open it up to be too tight there. Yeah, it's falling out on me. I wonder if I can't find it. There we go, it's through again. Hold on to it this time. Like I was saying, don't open it out and press it down too tight, because your wheel has got to be able to turn freely. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is to take the card back and lay that down. Take the card front and lay that down so that you've got what will be the card top, which you will have folded over and pressed down with the bone folder. So it'll be top to top, like that. And whatever method you like, I'm using a tape putter on a thingy. I'm going to add some tape along there. And I'm just going to move the flap over to the other side and press down on it so the front and the back are now joined together and they've got the hinge at the top. The next thing we need to do is to make the card base itself. So that is going to go down there like that, and you've got this little glue flap at the bottom, and we're going to add a good sided tape or glue or whatever your chosen method is to the little flap at the bottom. And holding that closed, if you fold your front down onto it and stick it onto your glue flap, now the card base will stand up by itself. Next thing we need is the card front cover, and I've just realised I've not put any foam tape on the back of there, so I'll get some out and we'll get my sticky scissors. Now, when we put this onto here, we don't want to put it onto this circle, so we only need to put it in the four corners, because obviously it will stop it from moving. So it would probably be best if you put it straight onto the front itself. I knew there was a reason why I hadn't put it on. We'll stick four pieces down into the corners. This foam tape is very sticky. It's made all my scissors very gungy. So good job that they're the those that clean easily. Must be non-stick. Down there like that. And what we're going to do is take the tape, the covering off the back of the double-sided foam tape. You need something with a bit of height this time, just to give you that little bit of clearance between this and the wheel. That's why we're using foam tape here. And then the card front itself, which we'll have cut out, and of course I've forgotten to say that we need to cut out the little window, haven't I? So, again, you've seen me do this before, and I need my pokey tool. There it is. I like to make a little hole in each of the four corners. It just helps when locating the corners with your knife, making sure not to get it in your fingers, mind. And then a steel edge ruler and a craft knife, and just join those holes up, otherwise we're not going to be able to see the numbers, are we? So we'll remove this one here. And turn it round. And the last one. And remove it. Get rid of any of the little bits. So we've now got a little window in the front through which the numbers are going to be seen. And standing it up, it's obviously going to go that way. Make sure you don't put it on upside down or back to front, or I'm sure I could manage that. And this, matching the corners, will fit on the front of your card. Ah, now then, it wants to be just a tiny little way in, and I have put it over to one side. You wouldn't normally be able to see the bottom of the wheel there, but I've put it slightly in the wrong place, but it still works. Now when we turn it, you can locate the correct number there in the wheel. I'll show you that on the other one in a bit, where it's been, where I've put it on properly. But then you've got decoupage to add to the front as well. And for that, I'm going to use silicone glue this time, because I want to add a little bit of dimension to it. And when I'm adding it with silicone glue, I like to add it onto the piece that I'm going to put the decoupage onto, because then I can see exactly where it's going to go. And I'm not going to get the glue on my hands when I'm trying to manoeuvre what could be a small piece onto the card itself. Just put that on there like that, and I'll find wherever I've put my little pieces. Move it out of the way. Okay, and here we have the hat, and I'm just going to shape it just a slight bit, and then that can sit on top of there. And then you've got gloves as well, which if I show you on this one here, this one's got Santa, this one here has got a penguin, that they're holding what is really a heart-shaped snowball. And I like to shape these just a tiny bit, and so with a pair of scissors, the handle off, I like to place them face down in the palm of my hand and just very gently shape them a little bit so then they're slightly rounded. And there should be another one here as well. And go on the same with the other one. Now with this one, especially on this side here, you've got to make sure you don't put any glue where it might go over your window. So on this one I'm going to place it, the glue, on the actual piece of decoupage so that I can make sure that it's out of the way. So this one here, wasn't it? I don't have to have his hands crossed, do we? And place it just at the top edge there. Same with the other one. And place this one on the other side, that it looks as if he's holding the snowball then. Pop that out of the way. For the back of the card, we have got a sentiment that you can add if you like. And perhaps I should have put this on before I added the decoupage. Place this on the back of the card. That's at a jaunty angle, like that. There are also other greetings on the card too that you can, on the sheets rather, that you can add if you want to. And then you've got the gift tag as well, which you can just fold in half and using a bone folder, and turn that into a gift tag too. So that you've got a nice little set to go there. And as I said before, they all come with their envelopes. Just clear these out the way, and we've got the one with Santa Claus here with his envelope as that, and then we have got the penguin one there, and the sheets that I showed you earlier, that one's got the Millie Moo cow as well, but in the blue this time. I think I've done some in pink as well. There are lots more that are going to be on the website too, so that's on craftsuprint.com. I'm Carol Clarke, and if you like my designs, just go to craftsuprint.com/Carol Clarke and you'll find I've got lots and lots there. Well, it might only be July, but Merry Christmas, and I hope to see you next time on Cup TV. Bye!